Next up is a young gun from Manchester City.
Mantella.
He's a self-admitted nerd when it comes to computers, science, and board games.
Please welcome the passionate Ville.
I am a millennial. I'm a proud millennial. And I don't want to use the word Generation Y, because it feels like to me that I'm trying to hide from these negative connotations or from these stereotypes of being a millennial. But I want to convince to you today that that's exactly what they are. They are stereotypes that you shouldn't take seriously. Because, come on, we are not a generation of ADHD patients, nor are we a generation of goldfishes. This, it's a smartphone, right? And I'm basically married to it. And it's one of the negative connotations that we are all married to our smart devices. But I want to show to you that it's not a weakness, but a strength. Because the smartphone, it's kind of a black box. You never really know what I'm doing while I'm using it. And it creates this illusion, this misconception that I must be wasting my time when I am using it. But why is that? Is it because I can play video games on it? Is it because I can, I don't know, binge watch Netflix for like 6 hours straight on a random Tuesday evening? Actually, one of the reasons why I am so incredibly proud to belong to this generation is because of our ability to take everything out of a small little object like the smartphone. I mean, it stirs up a lot of emotions. It's the ultimate tool for procrastination, the gateway to the dark playground. But also, it's the gateway to infinite knowledge. It's the passage to unlimited learning and the tool for optimal working. I'm a self-taught programmer and a technical leader, and I think the only reason why it was possible is because I have this, and I was born in an era where data was available to me 24/7. I mean, when I was in my little hometown of Mantsela, in the blistering cold, when I was waiting for the train, I had 5 minutes to take out the phone and read an online article about a coding framework. When I was on the train towards Helsinki for 40 minutes, I could spend watching an online tutorial on programming. And whenever I had an hour or more of uninterrupted time, I could take out my laptop and start programming. And honestly, I'm just a normal dude. I was never exceptional in math, or actually not even that good at it. And you can definitely ask my friends about my skills in human languages like Swedish. So if you see somebody on their phone, there is no reason to think that they're wasting time. It's like if I want to go to Switzerland, I'd rather take the plane instead of a car. Even though a road trip across Europe is definitely awesome, but if I want to get there fast, one of these methods of transportation is objectively more optimal than the other. This is a tool as long as you use it as a tool. And this is a waste of time if you let it use you. A unicorn company is defined as a privately held startup that is worth over $1 billion. And there's around 350 of them currently in the world. And they name these companies after this mythical creature because they are so incredibly rare. So what do you think a person needs to start, build, and run a company that is worth over $1 billion? Probably you think you need to work hard, probably need some dedication, need focus, right? Well, these are things that are usually said that my generation lacks. But interestingly, from all the current unicorn companies, about 1/3 were founded by a millennial. And if we look at the past 5 years, that number grows to over 50%. So how can my generation lack work ethics or dedication or focus if we are responsible for most of these startups? My generation gets things done because we know how to use this. So the next time you think of millennials, I ask of you, think of us as we actually are. Because we are a generation of information gatherers and data hunters. We are a generation of groundbreakers. And with the help of this, we are the generation with unlimited learning potential.